my cars. I will travel across the land, searching far and wide. Each Pokemon to understand the power that's inside.
Pokemon, gotta catch 'em all.
It's you and me. I know it's my destiny.
Time.
Pokemon Show, the Pokemania Show with me. What? Who am I? Help me out here.
You're Pokemaniac, Rick.
Yeah, I am. And who are you?
I'm Dragon Tamer Nate.
Dragon Tamer Nate. I forget these things, never mind.
Nice.
Fourth week in, indeed. Fourth show ever. I'm impressed.
I am as well.
I didn't think we'd make it past an hour in the first show.
It's going well, though.
I think it is. Hello to everybody in the Pokemon world. How are you all doing? We're doing all right. I'd like to know how you're doing. Get in touch with us, please, by texting in on 60777. Start your text message with StudyVox, then your name, then your message. Or you can email us, because that doesn't cost any money. And I like it when things don't cost money.
The freer, the better.
Except if I'm in the game corner, because, you know, the more money you're spending, the better the Pokemon you're getting.
Yeah.
Like Abra. Spend me some serious money on a Porygon.
Abra used to really annoy me trying to catch him on red because he used to teleport like a coward.
Why would you want to catch an Abra? Just go to Game Corner and buy him.
Yeah, I suppose.
You get him at like
I
level...
I think that's what I did in the end, actually.
You think you get him at like level 15. He's leveling once.
Sweet.
To get to Kadabra. And then he learns Confusion and everybody's happy. Some serious stuff, right? Anyway, what was I talking about? Email us, radio@studyvox.com. Alternatively, you can Twitter us, @StudyVoxFM.
Yeah, our very own Emma McGann is in charge of the tweet, so she'll be...
Because we're not allowed to be anywhere near that stuff.
No, it's...
I'm terrible at it.
We need to focus on Pokemon.
We need to focus on the Pokemon, not on the Twittering.
Also, you can head over to the Facebook page, Pokemania. If you search on Facebook in your search bar, Pokemania, it will come up, radio station. Or you can go to facebook.com/PokemaniaFM and And I've been uploading some stuff there this week that you can check out, new stuff. There's highlights from the World Championships, which of course we're going to go into later.
In Hawaii. That's where, oh man, serious.
I know.
It's like Fire Island, but not.
See, if you train hard, you could train your way to Hawaii.
Yeah, man.
I'd like to go there.
I want to go to Hawaii to talk about Pokemon and then have Pokemon battles with people.
From the video I watched, it looked amazing.
I haven't watched your video, but I saw that you posted a video and there seemed to be just two ladies with like Pokemon attire on.
Yeah, yeah,
like,
absolutely.
Well, boom.
It's very good. Check it out on the Facebook page.
Yes, please do that. What's coming up on today's show? We've got our usual mix of Pokemon related stuff, really.
It's all about Pokemon on the Thursday from 8 till 10. It's Pokey time.
If you were coming here thinking maybe, I don't know, like certain people wanted to talk about Digimon, we don't need that. Don't do that.
No.
Sort that out.
Sorry, Digi what? Digi who?
Stuff that. What's coming up on today's song? We have all our usual competitions. Who's that Pokemon?
Hang on. Wait, do your little jingle. Wait, here we go. Ready? Okay. You ready?
Who's that Pokemon?
Yep. Good work.
Oh, thanks. I think, yeah.
We're getting there.
Spending a lot of time on that. And then, yeah, we've got that. We've got our caption competition, which doesn't have a jingle, but I can make one up.
Oh, it's
right
a
now.
Funny one. I've seen the caption contest this
have
week.
You? Have you?
I do like it.
Good.
We've also got...
We'll be announcing the winners of those competitions from last week as well. So stay tuned. If you entered last week, I know you did. I did.
We've got episode of the week, which I'm looking forward to.
Oh.
We're on the third one now?
We are on the third one. Even though it's our fourth week, we're on the third episode.
Yeah. Because we did a Chansey operation for the first
standard
one, which is a special because it is amazing.
Brilliant. So. But what I love about our episode of the week section is it gives me an excuse to watch a Pokemon episode every week, and then I watch it, and then I come here and I tell you about the episode. It's brilliant fun for me.
It's brilliant. It is brilliant.
So I'm watching, making my way through. You are essentially starting a journey that I'm on, and you're all joining me whilst I watch the Pokemon episodes.
I'm really enjoying it.
Are you?
Yeah, I look forward to it.
Some people have said I maybe put a little bit too much drama into it for a kids' TV program. Those people are wrong.
Yeah, they are. They are. They can go and watch Digimon.
Digi what?
Digi who? We've also got Pokemon of the Week.
Yeah, we do.
And we've also got Pokemon Card of the Week.
Indeed. You'll be doing your Pokemon Card of the Week.
Yes, I will.
You know what? One week we should mix it up and I'll do my Pokemon Card of the Week and you do your Pokemon of the Week.
Okay.
And then maybe take notes and discuss.
Yeah, evaluate and discuss.
Exactly. I think we'll do that, you know, just to mix it up.
Yeah,
if we get bored of talking about Pokemon.
We've got Pokemon Battle as well.
Oh, we do.
We've sorted the video now. I'm touching wood, figuratively, because we have had some problems in the past, but we've sorted it. It should all be working good as new.
Well, I hope so. This one's on a new format. It's on Pokemon Stadium 2.
Yes.
Which is awesome.
And
I can't believe
it. It's me, Dragon Tamer Nate, against Ace Trainer James.
Or Cool Trainer. He changes week to week. Depending on how cool / ace he is at that precise moment in time. I believe a quick shout out to Camper Al, I believe, who's listening in.
Oh, hey, Al.
If he's not, I'll shout out again later. But Camper Al, everybody.
Camper Al.
Well done. I heard he's been having some problem with bug Pokemon recently.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Sneaky bug Pokemon getting
too many Weedles
all over the place, man. You just, even one got into our caption competition this week. It's just Weedles everywhere.
All about Weedle. We'll be showing the caption contest and what else? We'll be showing the card from Who's That Pokemon when we announce the winner from last week.
We will. You can see that all on our webcam, which hopefully you're looking at now. Let's wave at people at the webcam.
Oh, hey.
Oh, there. Oh, hey. Oh.
It is better if you're watching with video.
Stripey top.
Because we do have a lot of visual content as well to show.
Yeah, we do. I dance quite a bit.
So, we've got quite a lot coming up on today's show.
We do indeed. The battle will be taking part at 9 o'clock. Yeah.
Excellent.
It's a lot of stuff going.
So, as you may or may not know by now, we're trying to choose songs that are slightly Pokemon related, and it's getting harder each week.
Any suggestions would be helpful. Oh, I see what you've done.
It's kind of...
Did we not do that already?
No, we didn't.
Okay.
I'm sure.
I'm certain we
did. I'm hoping we didn't do that already. Should we play that next song?
We can. It's I remember giving the exact same speech that I'm about to give.
Oh, really?
See, like, you're walking between your towns and you're going through your routes and stuff like that, and you say, like, I don't know, you're rocking about in Peruta City, yeah? And you're like, oh, man, I really, really need to get to Pallet Town. Oh, and why wouldn't you? Pallet Town is where it's happening. And you're like, I can't really be bothered to walk all the way through Viridian Forest into Viridian City and then all the way down, you know, just to get me to Pallet Town. So what you need to do is you need to go to Celadon City, and you need to go to your left to Celadon City. And then there's a woman in a house who very helpfully gives you a HM. And that's... Oh. And I believe that's what this band, the Foo Fighters, have written this song about.
Learn to fly.
I think that's what it's about.
Learn to fly.
Yeah.
HMO.
Two. Could be wrong. Could be five.
It could be any one of them.
I think five serve. What, it was four? Four strength.
Four strength. Five serve.
It depends what game you're playing, though, because they changed.
Wow.
They went all the way as like HMO8 and stuff, like when they started adding Rock Smash and stuff like that.
Now, Flash, the move.
It originally,
was it a HM?
Originally was a HM, and then they changed it to a TM because...
Just, no one likes Flash.
Why would you? I just didn't teach any of my Pokemon Flash, and I just went walking around up to just like, I'll eventually. How big can this tunnel really be?
Yeah, you don't really need Flash.
You always walk into.
Plus, it's a really bad move, and I think I've noticed. I think they upped the power of some of the HMs as well to kind of make them, because people were complaining. Once you teach it to a Pokemon, you can't get Pokemon rid of it. Just, so at least make the move pretty good.
Yeah. You've got to have that Pokemon in your party.
Yeah.
Unless you're constantly just going back. Well, I mean, like, Fly's alright.
Yeah.
I quite
Surf's
like,
my favourite.
Surf is wicked. Although, in later generations, they added it, like, if you're in a 2v2 battle, then Surf affects everyone.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Even... So, constantly my Infernape was just getting smashed by Surf.
Yeah. So, what Poke-related stuff have you been up to this week, Rick?
So, I've been helping one of my friends out, because he's currently rocking his way through Heart Gold at the minute.
All right.
And he's been after some Pokemon, and because, you know, I got them.
You have got them.
I got most of them, so I thought I'd help him out, and I went and caught him a Snorunt. Because he wanted a Froslass. Now, the problem with that is, I'm walking around in my in Snow Point City up in Platinum. I'm playing it on Platinum. Walking around trying to find this Snorunt. So, of course, I'm wandering around going, why is there no Snorunts around? I'm just getting all these Swinubs and, like, Sneasels and stuff like that. Can't be dealing with that. I need my Snorunt. Later find out that, obviously, you can only catch it at night.
Oh.
He's like, oh, well, don't worry about it. Just catch it tonight. And I'm like, no. Change my time on my DS. Silly fool.
standard.
Shuckle Tamer Dan, this is. My friend Shuckle Tamer Dan.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm like, I changed my time on my DS. And I'm walking around. So I come across a Snorunt. And he's like, no, you can't do that. It's male. It needs to be female for it to be a Froslass. Kidding. Do you know how many times I came across male Snorunts?
Really?
Before I found a female one. I mean,
I bet the ratio is quite high.
It's mental. Having issues, constant issues finding it. Finally found one. Yeah. Use cut. Critical hit. What's that about? What's that? Angry. I was upset at the time.
I can imagine.
But he got worse because I gave him a game because I had to go to work. So he's playing on my game. I know. I'm not saying that you should just give your Pokemon games out to anybody who asks. Don't do that.
No.
Don't do that. Keep your game sacred. But I trust Shuckle Tamer Dan. So I gave him his game, my game, and I said, you go for, because he wanted a Gabite. Because, you know, nice dragon Pokemon. And he was walking around in this cave trying to find this Gabite, and he couldn't. And none of my Pokemon had Flash, so he's walking around in this dark cave trying to find Gabite. And then he finds this woman who goes, oh, can you escort me out? I can't remember what her name is now. It's a very funny moment. Maybe I'm not conveying it, but
excellent.
Finds the woman and she joins the party. So, like, he throws out a Pokemon and then the woman throws out a Pokemon and there's two Pokemon. So it's a double battle.
Yeah.
And every time he came against a Gabite, the woman would kill it before he could catch it. It was most amusing to watch him get worked up like that.
I can imagine.
Eventually took her out and sacked her off and went off
Absolutely.
And did it on his own. You know,
standard.
Classic Pokemon related strife there.
Good work.
That's been my Pokemon week summed up, Nate. What have you done, Pokemon wise?
So I've been working on my elite deck at the minute.
Oh yeah, yeah.
I'm hoping that I'm going to train myself to Hawaii next year.
I don't know whether it'll be in Hawaii.
No, it's
next
in.
Year.
I should know this.
You should know.
I completely
this.
Forgot. It's in somewhere.
It's definitely going to happen somewhere.
Yeah.
We'll find that out.
But I'd like to go to the next World Championships.
So you have to win. It's like heats, man. You have to win like lower heats. You have to be like the best.
I'm thinking of starting it.
Pokemon Carder in Great Britain.
I'm thinking of starting it.
Oh yeah, are you going to go for it?
Yeah. I think my deck's pretty much there now. I use for fire and water, fire and electric deck.
Yeah, we've been through the merits of your deck.
Yeah.
I like
very trainer based now.
Yeah. But I was reading about this the World Championships, and quite a lot of people are rocking the Darkrai and Mewtwo X.
Yes, they are.
They're loving that.
Both have been my featured Pokemon card of the week so far, for good reason. Darkrai is serious. and Mewtwo with his X ball attack.
You just love Mewtwo, don't you?
Yeah, I was so happy when I got that card.
Put him the right way up for you this
time. Oh, thank you.
Because you had a moan at me last week, because on the Pokemon...
He's my favourite Pokemon.
Right there, you can see it now on the webcam, our wonderful Pokemat for the Pokemon cards designed by Emma.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's wicked. We didn't buy this. You can see it better now.
Yeah,
Emma
McGann designed this.
Pokemon all over the place. And last time I put it up, and Mewtwo was upside down. So Nate obviously went in.
I wasn't happy. Although I'm a dragon tamer, Mewtwo is where I'm at. Actually, if you are interested, or if you have been already, if you head over to the Pokemon website, they're currently running a like a face-off at the minute. It's in the semi-final stage at the minute, so there's four Pokemon. You can vote which Pokemon you think is better. At the minute, it's Celebi versus Mew.
Ooh!
Or... And the other one is Mewtwo versus...
I don't know, man. I don't know why you're looking at me. It's got to be a serious Pokemon.
No, it's Rayquaza versus Mewtwo. It's a tough one.
What are you saying, Nate?
I've voted in the semi-finals. I voted for Mew and Mewtwo.
You went for Mew and Mewtwo?
Gen 1. See, Celebi, at the minute, the majority of the vote is with Mew, for Celebi versus Mew.
I mean, Celebi's like a grass psychic Pokemon. I don't know how I'm feeling about that.
Mew was the first Pokemon. Yes. he was the first Pokemon.
So what?
He started it.
So what? It doesn't mean he's better.
He does.
Surely that means, like, since Mew, there's been improvements along the way.
Nah, Mew started it.
Yeah, man.
And Mewtwo, it's just like an improved version of Mew.
Nobody sits there like, oh, check out my classic Game Boy that doesn't have colour or anything. Everyone's like, yeah, I'm rocking the DS right now.
Not the same.
Oh, yeah. Rocking the DS.
The 3DS XL has just come out.
Exactly.
Which looks awesome.
See, nobody cares about the Game Boy... Although, to be fair,
I still do love them.
Yeah.
Standard.
Maybe that was a bad example.
So anyway, yeah, that's been my week.
Has it?
Yeah, I've had a poker-packed week.
You have indeed, it seems. What's going to be happening
so,
on...
So, we should do that. Are you ready for the jingle? Should we do the jingle?
Oh, you want to do that? I'm not entirely sure where my sheet of paper
We've got the last week's winner to announce.
Just like, add some filler here, Nate, while I find my piece of
paper. Okay, Rick's going to find his piece of paper in the meantime.
Oh, I got it! I found it!
That was very quick.
Found it. Good filler, Nate.
Good filling. I had to say three words, maybe?
Good work on the filling. Right,
so, are we ready? We're going to do this jingle. Here we go.
Okay, I'm ready. Who's that Pokemon? That's right?
Yeah, it's completely right.
Who's that Pokemon is our first Pokemon competition of the night. Our first of two. You know, still counts.
Standard.
Basically, so, what we want you to do is I'm going to read out the description from the Pokemon games on the Pokedex of a Pokemon. You've got to guess what that Pokemon is. Previous weeks have been things like Zorok. Then we've had like...
Salamence.
And we... Yeah, we've had Pokemon like
and
that.
People seem to be getting it really quick.
You have trouble. You always go for Beedrill. And I think this week's going to be no different. You're going to go for Beedrill again.
Yeah, I might do.
One week I'm going to throw Beedrill in.
Yeah. So, we have some serious Pokemon masters listening because they get them like
some people get them that really quick. So what I'll do is I'll read out a description and you have to guess your Pokemon. If you'd like to enter the competition, what you have to do, you can text us. You can enter in a massive variety of ways.
So many ways.
Some of them won't be considered appropriate, but we'll take them anyway, like shouting out your window.
Yeah.
If you want to do that.
We might not hear, to be honest.
No, your chances are low of winning. But
you could send a Pidgey carrying...
A Pidgey?
Yeah, a Pidgey, because it's amazing. Carrying your answer.
With your answer, and then see what happens. But I would recommend either texting 60777, starting your text message with StudyVox, then your name, then your guess of a Pokemon. Alternatively, you can email us at radio@studyvox.com. You can then put your name and then your guess of a Pokemon. You don't need to start it with StudyVox. StudyVox is StudyVox. Just so you know. Or you can Twitter us at StudyVoxFM. You can go onto our Facebook and just plough your name on and your guess down right there. those are the ways that we will...
I mean, if you want to, you can give us a call in the studio.
Oh, yeah, you can do that.
If you're in the UK, you can call in on 01235 835 333. We'd love to have some pokey talk with you.
Who knows what we might talk about.
We've got loads to talk about. We can talk about Pokemon forever.
Till the mill tanks come home. That's
nice
right.
One. I like that.
Don't exclude people out of the UK if they wanted to ring in.
Oh, yeah. I mean, if you're outside the UK and you want to ring in, we have a lot of abroad listeners. Just what's the area code? It's plus 44 for the UK.
Yeah, it's plus 44.
Plus 44, 1235 835 333.
You just cut me off every time there. I understand that that might be a little bit of a...
an expense.
Pokeball ache. So...
Yeah.
Never mind.
Any of the ways, fine, as long as you get
I believe you can see all this scrolling along the bottom of your webcam.
Yep.
I don't know whether I'm doing that in time or not, but, you know, whatever. Or the webcam's even on me. Hopefully not. I mistake.
So, yeah, and if you are lucky enough to be one of our winners, you win the actual card that Rick is going to explain.
For example, say if I was doing Beedrill, you'd win a Beedrill Pokemon card.
I would love that.
Yes, you would.
And you also win a booster pack, am I right?
A booster pack containing 10. Count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 cards. Official Pokemon trading card
to
game.
To add to your cards. Collection. Or
already beefy collection, yeah. I'm assuming.
If you,
as
yes.
It should be. Right, we've explained what's going on. I think I should just carry on straight away with it. Now, this explanation is from the Pokedex in the Heart Gold games. Now, that's Gen 4. Generation 4, you can play that on the DS. It's a pretty good game. In fact, I would say the Heart Gold game is probably my favourite of all the Pokemon games so far, just for the sheer amount of Pokemon you get for your money.
I'd have to agree with you on that.
You catch some serious Pokemon, don't you?
Yeah, and it's such a bit long, big game as well.
It's wicked. You're in Johto and you can go to Kanto.
You catch... There's so many Pokemon
it's
you can
awesome.
Catch.
But this explanation is from that, and it's from Heart Gold, and the information is... It flies so silently through the dark on its four wings that it may not be noticed, even when nearby. Do you want that again?
See, I'm not going to go for Beedrill, but yeah, I'd like to hear it again.
It flies so silently through the dark on its four wings that it may not be noticed, even when nearby. Indeed.
Four wings.
Yep, four wings. I'd just say, I'm not into giving hints, but the things that you got to look at there is four wings and dark. Those are the things I'd say. Not the type dark, but just where would it be that's dark? Yeah.
Yeah.
I think people have got it here. I think you're all wrong. But anyway, I will be giving you another clue some point during the next hour and a half.
Yeah, I mean...
And I'll be repeating that clue.
Would you like to announce... Should we announce the card from last week?
We can indeed, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, last
week...
Have
you got the card ready to go
up? I have got the card ready to go up.
We'll slap that card right up.
We're going to stick the card up on the webcam, so if you are watching us, which hopefully you are, you can see it right about now. The card from last week was, Rick...
Yanmega. There he is. Funky bug Pokemon.
Pretty good card, actually. 100 HP. He's got a little pokey ability.
He's pretty beastly. Remember, like, the description was its jaw power is immense. It bites enemies apart while flying through the air.
Oh, yeah, that was it, yeah.
That was off the top of my head. And its wing power can uproot trees when it takes off.
I like the fact it's resistant as well by 20 hit points to fighting, which is quite cool.
Why is that cool?
Because I come up a lot against fighting. I don't know why, but fighting seems to destroy me.
Really?
Yeah, because my electric Pokemon.
Yep, bad times.
So, yeah,
bad times for that.
It's a good card. It's a very good card. So the winner from last week was Lindsay from Hammersmith.
Lindsay from Hammersmith.
So good work, Lindsay. You'll be winning this card and a booster pack containing how many, Rick?
That'd be 10.
10. 10 official Pokemon cards to add to your collection. 10. And the image shows that it is... You can't really see on the image, but it is a... it's a shiny Yanmega. So you will be winning a shiny Yanmega.
Wow. We're nice to you people, aren't we?
We are. We are indeed.
I want that card. maybe I won't get it, but I want it.
Yeah, it's absolutely.
Okay.
So don't forget, you can text in on 60777 with your answer. Start your text with the word StudyVox, or email at radio@studyvox.com and tweet at StudyVoxFM.
I'm gonna give it a readout quickly.
Yeah, let's
just
do it
again. It flies so silently through the dark on its four wings that it may not be noticed, even when nearby. Did you like the dramatic pause?
I did. Torture effect.
That's what I do.
So, I think we should have some music.
I do indeed, and I think the music that we pick should be along the same lines. I think we're going to go for a HM-based
music night. We'll see how far we get with this, because
there's like eight of them, so yeah. We've got eight songs.
So, yeah.
This one is... So, like, you're rocking around. I can't exactly remember the route, but you're about to go to the Elite Four on, like, your silver. And to get to the Elite Four, you need to go through a cave. And in the cave, there's a problem there because there's something blocking you.
Oh, no.
And you're like, oh. So you've got to go and get yourself this HM that allows you to transverse these water objects. And... In order to get to the Elite Four, because if you go into the Elite Four and you don't have this HM, or you've not beaten the gym leader that allows you to use this HM, you're not ready for the Elite
Four.
They don't call it for the Elite Four. They don't call it the Elite Four, so you just take it on.
They don't call it the Casual Four.
No.
It's Elite.
Yeah.
It's, you know what I mean?
It's not the pretty good, but most people should be able to sort it. It's Elite. Elite.
Followed by the Champion.
There he is.
So this song's Waterfalls.
By TLC.
Yesterday, but too many stories. storms have come and gone, leaving a trace of not one God given ray. Is it because my life is ten shades of gray? I pray all ten fade away, sell the praise and for the 7 days. And like his promise is true, only my faith can undo the many chances I blew to bring my life to an end. Clear blue and unconditional skies have dried the tears from my eyes, no one lonely cries. My only leading hope is for the folk who can't cope with such an enduring pain that it keeps them in the pouring rain. Who's to blame for tuning in into your own vein? What a shame you're shooting aim for someone else's brain. You claim the insane and aim to stay in time for falling prey to crime. I say the system got you victim to your own mind. Dreams are hopeless aspirations and hopes are coming true. Believe in yourself, the rest is up to me. Yeah.
I know that says don't go chasing waterfalls, but I mean, like, if you want to get to the Elite Four, I think you're probably going
to
have
to chase that waterfall.
So disregard everything that TLC have just said to you.
Absolutely.
There you are. I think it's worth pointing out that all of our cards that we send out as prizes come as from our card supplier and therefore sponsor, NC Games.
NC Games.
So thank you, NC Games, for all of your
absolutely
help in everything that you're doing. Quick thing, Alex Hart, if you're listening, book a week off now.
Absolutely. He'll know what that means.
I don't even know what that means.
No.
I don't even know what's going on. Right, what section are we going for
we're
now?
We're going for... Do you want me to do the jingle for this, or do you want to
do it? Is there a jingle for this?
Maybe
you
not.
Do the jingle for this. What's this called?
It's here we go. I'll give it a go. Here we go.
Yeah, yeah. Go on, cool.
Tales from Pallet Town.
I thought you just news.
I could have just got news. But yeah, Tales from Pallet Town. It is our news section where we bring you all the Poke news. Well, most of the Poke news that you need to know. Any new big happenings.
Continue.
So this week, well, you know what's been going on this week. If you've been looking at the Facebook page, if you have liked our Facebook page, which is facebook.com/PokerManiaFM, you will have seen that I've been posting some stuff on there this week. I've posted a video with highlights from the World Championships of the trading card game.
Not just the trading card game,
no,
also
and the
actual game.
Amazing. And it was in Hawaii, which fantastic. And nice I believe place. That if you make it to the final, Pokemon fund your travel to Hawaii, if you made it to the final.
Wow.
Yeah, I know.
Serious cakes.
It is serious. So, the 2012 World Championships took place. And it was really... apparently, it was a massive success. I'm ashamed. I was gutted that I couldn't be there.
I would have loved to go.
Yeah.
Next year, Nate,
we'll set it as
a challenge.
We'll definitely
You can
that.
Go on the Pokemon website and check out all the winners and all the... Like, there's lots of cool photos and some just a blow-by-blow account, I believe.
Absolutely.
Of what's gone down.
Yeah, I mean, check out the Pokemon website. It's all there. Also, at the moment, talking Pokemon World Championships, if you own Pokemon Black or Pokemon White, you can...
I know I do.
I know I
both
do.
Both of them.
You can actually download a special edition Sea Gear at the moment. It's the World Championships 2012. It's got like a little logo of Pikachu. It looks pretty cool, to be honest.
Is it the one with the tiki thing?
I think so, yeah. It's really cool.
Yeah, it's
if,
cool.
Again, if you head over to our Facebook page, Pokemania, I've posted it on there, the picture of the Sea Gear and the password. You need to get it. So, you need to go through the Pokemon Black and White's global link. Use that password that I've put on the
Facebook.
I think
you can use that in your Sea Gear.
Yeah.
There's also the crystal one. There's a Sea Gear that's a crystal. It's just like a crab rock thing. Like,
wicked.
I don't know why I'm doing that. I'm making a face of like what it
yeah,
is.
Yeah, if you
I'll do that
the webcam.
To the webcam.
Here we go. Look, here. So that's Rick's impression of crystal. It's a good one.
I'm sorry about that. If you just saw that, that's I'm sorry about that.
Yeah, so it's all been about Pokemon World Championships this week, to be honest. But let's not forget the release of the new expansion for the trading card game.
Well, it's like in a couple of days, right?
Yeah. Dragon's Exalted.
Exalted,
yeah. Something like that.
It means like really... I tell you what it means. Really awesome.
It means new dragon type.
That's exactly what it means.
And
you're looking forward to
it. Oh, I am. I really am, because I'm definitely going to have at least one dragon type in my deck.
See, it's interesting to think, seeing as the more championships have gone off and like certain cards have been used.
Yeah.
That how people's decks are going to change with the introduction of the dragon type.
That's what keeps Pokemon fresh.
What trainers are we going to get? What fun new trainers are we going to get?
I'm so excited. I'm definitely going to use... I'm hoping to get it. I haven't got it yet. I'm definitely going to use Rayquaza, though. Rayquaza X if I get it, because its energy is fire and electric.
And that's you, man.
Which is perfect.
It's all about you.
So I definitely want that card.
Yeah, we'll be demoing those decks next week, live on air.
Yeah, we will.
But... If you want to, you can go across to a gentleman called Jay Witz.
Oh, we love Jay Witz.
He's on YouTube. He's already got hold of them because apparently, well, he's in America, so obviously.
Yeah, he got them last week, actually. He had them quite early.
Well, he is in America, isn't he?
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
I mean, they've come out there. They don't come out
here for another week.
In Britain.
Yeah, it's about a week later. But yeah, check out Jay Witz on YouTube because... we love Jay Witz, and he's got a good demo of the decks.
Yeah, you can check out his demo. That'll be more serious. Ours will be... I'll certainly be laughing at...
Yeah. Oh, and when we say decks, we mean themed decks. They've released, with this new expansion, as well as booster packs, they've released two themed decks, which are set decks that you can buy from the shop. If you're in the UK, they're around £10. I'm not sure about abroad. But, yeah, they're set decks, ready-to-play decks. So we'll be demoing them next week.
Boom.
So
that's what we'll be doing.
Well, at least not try before you buy, but
visually look at.
Yeah. We'll be going through it in some detail anyway.
Visually look at, as opposed to any form of other looking at stuff.
Yeah.
Never mind.
Never mind.
Also, what I found quite interesting has been the release of a new... I don't know whether it's a game. I'd just say Aid to Life. A Pokemon-themed Aid to Life.
This is amazing.
Which I saw and just thought, you know what? I can already do that, but I'm going to learn to again. Pokemon have released a Learn to Type with Pokemon game aid to life, like I said.
Yeah,
and I'm certainly going to get hold of that and learn how to type.
If I think Pokemon should really go down this education with Pokemon route, because if I was in school and it was all about related to Pokemon, I'd
certainly know my times table better if Charizard was teaching me.
Exactly.
Just in like one of those, you know, teacher
flat
caps.
Cap things, yeah. Not flat cap, but
I can't remember. Anybody know what they're called?
Something like, board. I'm sure it's something like a graduation hat almost.
A graduation hat.
Yeah.
Charizard in one of those and like, you know, a clipboard. Just going, I definitely have learned to count better.
Yeah.
I think I would have done better
in life.
I like the
sound effect for Charizard.
And I'm no Brizzy Voices.
No. Oh, check out Brizzy Voices as well on YouTube. We love Brizzy Voices.
Boom. That's all I have to say about that.
So have you got any tales from Pallet Town?
Any what, me?
Yeah, have you got any...
Are you not cool with my learn to type with Pokemon?
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, that's the only
news
I need.
That's really all the news that's going on.
That's what I'll be doing the next week.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Excellent. Let's carry on with our themed songs in which, you know, you need a HM to...
The HM themed.
To play the song. And this song, well, you know, you're rocking about in the Safari Zone. No, wait, that's not right. That's not...
It's not Safari Zone.
No, Safari Zone's the other one, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, I've messed it up. I've epic failed on the Pokemon front. This song is what happens when there's a boulder in your way.
What do you do, man?
There's a boulder in my way. Luckily, I have me a fighting Pokemon. Possibly a Machamp. I'm not saying you don't have to have a Machamp, but it could be a Machamp. And you're like, well, fortunately, this Pokemon has learnt this HM, and I got this. And my Pokemon, as a result, is now stronger by Kanye West. That don't kill me, can only make me stronger. I need you to hurry up, man, 'cause I can't wait much longer. I know I got to be right, man, 'cause I can't get much stronger. Man, I've been waiting all night, man, that's how long I've been on ya. Let's get lost tonight. You could be my black Kate Moss tonight. Play secretary on the ball tonight. And you don't give a f*** what they all say, right? Awesome, the Christian and Christian Dior. Damn, they don't make them like this anymore. I ask, 'cause I'm not sure. Do anybody make real s*** anymore? Bow in the presence of greatness. 'Cause
right now that has forsaken us. You should be honored by my lateness, that I would even show up to this place. So go ahead, go nuts, go ace. Especially in my pastel on my page. Act like you can't tell who made this new gospel, homie. Take six, and take this, haters.
That don't kill me, can only make me stronger. I need you to hurry up now, cause I can't wait much longer. I know I got to be right now, cause I can't get much stronger. Man, I've been waiting all night, man. That's how long I've been on ya.
Me like it.
I don't know if you get a man or not, if you made plans or not. God put me in your plans or not. I'm tripping, this drink got me saying a lot. But I know that God put you in front of me. So how the hell could you front on me? It's a thousand yous, it's only one of me. I'm tripping, I'm caught up in the moment, right? Cause it's Louis Vuitton dine night. So we gon' do everything the kind like. Heard they do anything for a Klondike. Well, I'll do anything for a Blondike. And she'll do anything for the limelight. And we'll do anything when the time's right. Baby, you're making it
faster, stronger. That don't kill me, can only make me stronger. I need you to hurry up now, cause I can't wait much longer. I know I got to be right now, cause I can't get much stronger. Man, I've been waiting all night now, that's how long I've been on ya.
Like I never told you. Don't act like I 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 told you. Baby, you're making it
better, faster, stronger.
That don't kill me, can only make me stronger. I need you to hurry up now, cause I can't wait much longer. I know I got to be right now, cause I can't get much stronger. Man, I've been waiting all night, man. That's how long I've been on ya.
I feel stronger just for listening to that.
I feel like Hitmonchan right now.
HMO4, that is strength. Yeah. I was right earlier when I said HMO2 was fly.
Really?
Yeah. I just went on Bulbapedia and figured it out. There's a gap in my knowledge on the HMs, but now I know them all.
Good work.
And we have, of course, that was Kanye West with HMO4. And before that, we had TLC with HMO7. So...
why don't they rename those songs?
To that, yeah. We've got some more HM-based... I don't know why they always say, like it's HM01. They haven't had a HM10, so why don't they just say HM1? Don't know what that's about.
They're saving themselves for HM10.
Oh, maybe in the new black and white there's going to be HM10 and it's going to be something stupid like, stupidly awesome like breakdance. I don't know.
Yes.
Maybe I shouldn't come up with moves for Pokemon, but, you know, there we go.
Breakdance, indeed.
Let's go on with our next section.
Yeah, what is it, Rick?
Oh, this is definitely my episode of the week.
Now, would you like the story effect with no backing?
I'd like no backing, but I'd also enjoy, like,
some backing live backing
from you guys.
Okay. Actually, before, we can work on that.
Before I do the episode, I'd like to give a few shout outs. Sorry, Alex Hart, for shouting at you live on air, and thank you, Emma, for telling me to dance more on webcam. I will certainly do that, but let's give a shout out to Leon McGregor and Wazzy 888. Yeah, we go.
Thanks for listening, guys.
There's a website address. I can't really say that on air,
but you can head over to wazzy88.dev/deviantart.com.
You've said that completely wrong.
Have I said that wrong?
What are you even looking at?
I can't read it from this far away.
We'll post the link of what you should... Yeah. Actually, I'm going to look at it now.
Let's post the link. We're going to post this link you should all check out on Facebook. And it is amazing. We've just seen it and it's incredible.
You should definitely look... We'll post the link on our Facebook. Get on that right now. It's artwork.
Yeah, we'll post that on Facebook
because it's
a piece of art that we don't... Words will just ruin it. Yeah. Just go and look at it.
Just look at it.
Even Ace Trainer James says, wow.
Wow. Okay, right, let's get on with our episode. Well, anyway, thank you for showing that.
Yeah,
that
cheers for listening, awesome, guys.
Let's get on with our episode of the week. And today's episode of the week is episode 3 in the original Pokemon Indigo League series. And episode 3 is entitled... I can't remember, what was it? Ash Catches a Pokemon!
Yeah, it is. Now, stop the backing for you.
Oh, thank you. But, I mean, like, if you guys could just add some oohs and ahs. Okay. And yeah, like that. But maybe wait until I start talking.
Okay.
Okay, so if you remember shut up. This episode picks up from last week where Ash and Misty were heading into Viridian Forest after just coming out of Viridian City. And it's called Ash Catches a Pokemon. So if you don't know what's going to happen, well...
You've got a lot to look forward to.
Yeah, you do. Okay, so Ash is... He's in Viridian Forest, and obviously he's coming up against, well, one of the standards of Viridian Forest, a Caterpie. A Caterpie's just rocking around. So Ash being Ash just immediately lobs his Pokeball at this Caterpie, and the Caterpie's like, give me a Pokeball noise. Give me a Pokeball noise.
I don't know what...
Thanks. That's all I wanted, okay, man. So, and the Caterpie gets pulled inside the Pokeball, and you know how it does. It hits the ground, and then the red light's still on the ball, and it's going beep, 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 beep. Ash and Misty step. Ash has got that face, that Ash face.
Anticipation.
That standard Ash face. Misty and Pikachu are just looking on, and then beep, 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 and then the red light goes out, and it becomes obvious that Ash has caught a Caterpie. Ash reacts in a suitably lame way by going, yes, and running at it. That's my Ash impression. You a fan?
I am a fan.
And picks up the Pokeball and he's well happy. Look at him. He's caught a Caterpie. What the stuff he has to learn. But he's caught his first Pokemon. And he runs circles around Misty, making Pikachu dizzy. Pikachu's like, whoa. In cartoons, things get dizzy by the swirly
eyes. Absolutely.
That stuff happened. So anyway, Pikachu's probably happy because now he doesn't have to put up with Ash. There's a Caterpie along for the ride. So Ash brings out his Caterpie, and Caterpie appears, and guess who's afraid of Caterpie?
It's got to be Misty.
Misty. As Caterpie appears, Misty runs away, she hides behind a tree, and Ash is like, oh, don't worry, Caterpie, I'm not afraid of you, crawl up onto my shoulder. But Caterpie spots Misty and immediately runs over to her and rubs up on her leg, despite Misty obviously being unimpressed by this. Caterpie's just like, nah, I'm having me a piece of this.
Yeah.
Goes up to Misty, goes for it, standard.
Senses her fear.
Misty comments about Caterpie and bugs being... disgusting. I believe the exact term she uses, disgusting bug. You can tell that Caterpie's quite hurt by this comment.
Oh.
His eyes get wobbly. It's bad times for Cappy. Misty, you are just uncool.
It's a bit heartless.
You're well uncool. Anyway, Ash is like to Cappy, man, I'm sorry. I don't think you're disgusting. I think you're awesome. You're a little bug Pokemon. Look at you. You're cool. And but Cappy, inconsolable, man. So Ash decides to hang out with Cappy. So Misty thinks, I will hang around with Pikachu. But that irritates Ash, you know, as it would. If you had a nice Pikachu and then Misty was trying to, you know, befriend it, how would you feel about that?
Oh, it's not good.
I wouldn't, especially seeing as Ash and Pikachu's relationship is pretty rocky right now.
It is.
Nobody knows
what's going
on.
They've been through a lot already, but yeah. It's still not right.
But anyway, they're carrying on through the episode and Misty is just going on about this Caterpie. She's like, it's her words, not mine. It's bug Pokemon are one of the three most disgusting things.
Does it go into detail about what the other two
are? She does. Carrots, peppers, and then bugs.
Strange.
Misty's not getting a lot of like vitamin C. She's got to sort that out, Misty. If you're not eating carrots and peppers. But anyway, Ash loves carrots and Ash loves peppers, but he enjoys Caterpie more, and he's upset that Misty has hurt Caterpie's feelings, you know. But you know, they carry on through the forest, and then Ash decides that he doesn't want anything to do with Misty anymore.
Really?
Yeah. Why would you? You just don't like my Pokemon. You don't like me. Go away. But anyway, Misty's still following her, and she's just like, look, you ain't getting rid of me because you broke my bike.
Yeah.
So that went down.
So Ash owes Misty, to be fair.
Pretty much, yeah. Like, he owes her one bike or, I don't know, something of similar value.
Yeah.
And if you go to the, like, Cerulean City shop, those bikes are not cheap. So.
No, I always have to wait till I got a voucher.
Yeah. Luckily, this guy is just all about giving out the vouchers.
Yeah, he's...
Okay, anyway, it's getting quiet, but, you know, Ash is just like, yeah, no, we cool. We'll sleep out here in Viridian Forest, you know, standard. What's the worst that can happen? There's only Beedrills flying about. Ash. Idiot. So they go to sleep, and the next day, Misty is the first to wake up, but do you know what the first thing she sees is?
What?
Caterpie sleeping next to her.
Oh, no.
How can you imagine Misty feels about
it? I imagine she freaks out.
She goes proper mental, mate. She goes absolutely crazy. She screams, shocking Ash and Pikachu into like awakeness, and she angrily demands that Caterpie is returned to his Pokeball, which again upsets Caterpie. I mean, Caterpie, yeah, just man up a little bit, all right?
Yeah, he's a bit sensitive, this Caterpie.
Yeah, it's only Misty. I mean,
yeah.
Although it is Misty. Ash likes you, but, you know, that's what it is. And Ash gets angry, utters some, you know, smart remarks, as only Ash can.
Yeah.
And, Ash demands that Misty apologises and tries to coax Caterpie out from where he is hiding. But then a wild Pidgeotto swoops across and lands in a bush, feeding on a worm. Now, we've had this question before, like, what do Pokemon eat? And Pidgeotto's here, he's going at this worm, and it's clearly a worm, it's not a Pokemon.
It's not a Weedle,
a worm Pokemon. It is a worm, so obviously there are animals.
Or at least insects.
Yeah.
Among the Pokemon community.
So there you go. But Ash, being obviously with the goal of being the best Pokemon trainer ever, is like, well, I'm having me this Pidgeotto. But he scans it with his Pokedex, obviously, first.
Yeah.
Ash not being the kind of guy to just roll into a battle without knowing what he's up against. So he wants to catch it, so he lobs his Pokeball at it, but Pidgeotto is just like, nah, smacks it away with his wing. What? Pidgeotto don't care about no ball.
No.
So Misty's just like, only a real trainer would weaken the wild Pokemon before he tried to catch it. It's my Misty impression.
Good work.
Thank you. So Ash decides that... she says that you only caught Caterpie because it was weak. Missed.
Another diss at Caterpie.
What's that about?
Throwing these backhanders.
I know, right? And Ash gets angry, and then he just blindly decides, you know what, Caterpie, let's do this. you take Pidgeotto down.
Clearly not knowing his types.
Not knowing his types at all. And we all know that Pidgeotto, let's be honest, it's just a buffer Pokemon than Caterpie.
Yeah, it's second stage of Pidgey.
But I mean, this is this is the Pokemon. You're right. And this is the Pokemon TV program. So anything could happen. We've all seen it. We all know
what's going to happen.
Who knows what Pokemon could beat what Pokemon? Ash's Pokemon takes down an Onix for crying out Sharon, honestly. But wow. Still, we never know. And then, so Ash sends out his Caterpie, and I'll tell you what happens, yeah? What happens is we take a break.
Oh, is that the end of the first half?
That's the end of the first half, guys. It's coming up to 9 o'clock, and I
know. Which means it's the battle time.
It is the battle time. But first, I feel we'll go on with a song, and then we'll play the battle.
You sure?
I'm pretty tired, man. I'm pretty tired. I don't think anybody's gonna get really angry if we play the battle out of three. Are you?
Let's play the battle then. Okay, we're 8 seconds to nine, so let's play the battle. So this week is a Pokemon Stadium 2 battle.
Oh, Pokemon Stadium 2 is one of the coolest things ever.
Yeah, it is.
It's such a good game. It's on the DS. We played it on the computer through no foul play at all. It's all perfectly fine.
Yeah, absolutely.
But yeah, Pokemon Stadium 2 is the game after Pokemon Stadium.
And again, it was me, Dragon Tamer Nate, against Ace Trainer James.
And if, as we all remember, we've had a couple of battles before. Nate,
it's
you won the first
at the moment.
You won the first Pokemon card battle, and
James
won
the DS game.
DS battle. So who will win this one?
Here's battle three.
Standard free 3v3. Take it away. Cool. Right, apparently I'm commentating live. Anything goes in this free battle between Nate and James. Let's see what's happening. Look at the Pokemon they've chosen. Very different. James has got himself... James is player one. He's got himself an Arcanine, a Gengar, and a Tyranitar. I quite like that choice. Nate's got an Alakazam, a Suicune, Blastoise. Is this okay? I don't know. Is this okay, James? Make your mind up. He's all ready. It's okay. Nate... Well, let's see which Pokemon goes first. I bet they get to pick. Oh, look at that. Just classic graphics. Some sweet, sweet fit images there. Gengar tonguing it hard. Gengar versus Alakazam. So Gengar would be cool trainer James's, and Alakazam would be Nate's there. Just standard circling view. Look at the moves they've got there. Nightshade, Nightmare, some serious ghost moves. I'd go with Hypnosis to start with. I have a feeling that Alakazam's going to be the faster Pokemon. I'm not really sure about the Pokemon Stadium 2, what the stats are like. James is having problems, it seems, and can't decide on a move. I think Nate's going to go with a Psybeam. Yep, I'm right, and Alakazam is pretty quick. This could... Know your types. Psychic's going to... It's super effective. Oh, look at that, 19 health! Wow, that's a serious move. James is using Hypnosis. Oh, the Gengar's attack missed. That's not good. James is off to a very bad start. If I were him, I'd get rid of this. I'd take this Gengar out of the equation now and put his Tyranitar out there because it's dark. He is not, and Alakazam is using Psybeam. This is the end for Gengar. Boom. Gengar flaps his arms about. Down he goes. Unfortunate James. That's one Pokemon down for James. Nate's still on his free. Is Alakazam still on full health? 269 HP. What's he going to do now? Bring out your Tyranitar. It's a sweet-ass dark Pokemon. Rock dark. What? There's no will... Are you trying to send out Gengar again, James? Poor effort. Arcanine. All right, that's maybe not the Pokemon I would have chose at that point, but...
I know he's pretty awesome. I do like Arcanine. I think he's quick as well, but we'll see. What moves he got? Flame Wheel, Roar, that's helpful. Leer, Extreme Speed. Now, I do like Extreme Speed. It means he goes first. It's like a quick attack thing, but I mean a bit beefier. Let's see what happens. Alakazam goes quicker. No, he doesn't go quicker. Nate's withdrawn him. What Pokemon's he sending out now? Blastoise. Here he is. Look how awesome Blastoise looks. It's just sweet. This isn't good because Extreme Speed, I don't think this is going to do a lot of damage. Blastoise with his high defense. I don't know. He's now down to 191 HP. The very similar Pokemon HP-wise, 325 to 311. That's a good move by James, taking your Arcanine away. But actually, he's got a Tyranitar, which is Rock Dark. Still going to be weak against water, so I'm guessing Hydro Pump. Yep, Hydro Pump. There it is. Boom. Oh, his attack missed. I did not see that coming. That is a lifeline. Who knows what's going to happen now? But Tyranitar's moves probably aren't going to be helpful against Blastoise. And Blastoise is quicker. But look at the mega amount of HP that Tyranitar has. 343, but now he's down to 66. That's not good. And he uses Bite. I don't think that's going to do a lot. 129 HP to 66 HP. This looks like Blastoise is going to win it. He could change his Pokemon out for Arcanine. I think Arcanine's got quite a high defense, so special defense, so that might be helpful. But we'll see what's going on. He did not. Blastoise goes first. It's an awkward situation when Blastoise is the fastest Pokemon in a battle, but he is, and he's taken Tyranitar down. That is 3 Pokemon to 1. This is not looking good for James, and it's quite the mountain to climb for Arcanine here, but if there's one Pokemon that I think can do it, he can. Here he is. There he is. Look how awesome he looks. Man, I want an Arcanine in real life. Ride it around. You know, it'd be sweet. Anyway, Nate's still got his Alakazam on full health and a Suicune on full health. Suicune, of course, is a water Pokemon as well, so will probably come off better against Arcanine. But we'll see what goes on. I imagine Nate's going to use a Hydro Pump again. Let's see what James is going to use. I'll go with Extreme Speed there because Flame Wheel's not going to help. Oh, Nate's taking Blastoise away. Interesting. Interesting decision. What's he going to bring out? His Suicune. Okay, so he swapped a water Pokemon for a water Pokemon, but I suppose it's got more health. 343 HP. That's mega. Let's see what Arcanine does. That's Flame Wheel there. That won't be effective against Suicune. See what's going to happen. Again, use Extreme Speed. Or maybe even a Leer. Drop his defense. That'd be good for your Extreme... Flame Wheel? Fire against water? James, we need to go over your types. We need to go over your... It's not very effective, man. Bubble Beam. I don't see Bubble Beam being a big problem to Arcanine. Let's see what happens. Oh, well, there you go. Pretty much half of his health has gone there. 163 HP points left. I'm not going to lie to you, Arcanine's in a little bit of trouble here. You might as well roar your way out of the battle, to be honest with you. But Flame Wheel, you know, classic fire on water move, you know. It's not very effective, but that's not going to stop James. Bubble Beam. This could be the end of Arcanine. I don't know, I think he might just survive this. It'd be fine. A critical hit! You don't need that right there. That's game over. Arcanine is fainting, and he's making it melodramatic about it as well. Arcanine. Anyway, end battle. Nate's the winner.
Well commentated, Rick.
Whoa.
What did you think to that battle?
Whoa. I mean, like, I won't lie to you. James has definitely made some errors in that battle. Mostly the use of fire moves against water Pokemon.
Yeah, I think I came pretty lucky with the types I picked.
Yeah.
Because we had the super effective with Alakazam against Gengar.
Did you just pick 3 Pokemon each?
Yes.
Or did you pick 6 Pokemon and then use...
No, we picked 3.
You just picked 3?
Yeah.
And you picked 2 water Pokemon?
Yeah.
Well, who am I to judge? I mean, it paid off pretty well.
I love Suicune. And the reason why I brought my Blastoise back halfway through that is because I wanted Suicune to get a little bit of camera time on air.
Yeah.
Oh, he's a wicked Pokemon.
Fair enough. All yeah. Right. I knew what I was doing in the bag.
Yeah, I knew it was in the bag, and I thought, why not let Suicune have a little go?
That's showmanship, right?
Oh,
there.
It is.
Pokemon showmanship.
Extra points.
So that's 2-1 to Nate. James, how are you feeling about that?
He's pretty upset.
He looks pretty upset. But who knows, next week we'll have another battle. Maybe you can bring it back to level. Maybe nail. I mean, he pretty much destroyed you there. Three Pokemon still alive.
It's how I rolled.
Oh. Nate. Good work. So that was our Pokemon battle. We'll be doing the same thing next week. Maybe not Pokemon Stadium 2. I haven't decided yet.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll go with Pokemon Stadium 1. Maybe we'll not.
Maybe we will. Maybe not.
We've got another question in.
Okay.
From Glory. We keep getting these questions.
Oh, is this Glory O'Shea?
Yeah. And okay. They're always fun, and I will answer them. Hi, Rick and Nate, / Nate and Rick. I like how she does say Rick and Nate. / Nate and Rick.
Yeah, I like that.
I think Rick and Nate's where it's at. Why is the mirror of Ash young boy who make... What? Oh, why is the mirror of Ash... I don't understand what's going
on. Let's have a look at this question.
Yeah, you read it.
Why is the mirror of Ash young boy who name...
Young.
Oh, of Ash young...
Boy who makes leaving on my porch. I think James should be hero. Nice straight back. Good figure. Not like Rascal. I do not understand Nintendo's thinking. They reflect poor behaviour, bad example to young. See, I think it's basically about is Pokemon a good example for children?
Well,
I say yeah.
Yeah, I think it teaches a lot of lessons. There's a lot of moral meanings behind Pokemon episodes.
Really?
Yeah.
Example.
the main theme throughout Pokemon is, you know, you see these Pokemon. There's an episode where there's a trainer who's really tough on his Pokemon, and it's all brute force and everything. But Ash, the whole kind of thing with Ash giving his Pokemon love, attention, and being friends with them kind of gives a good message to viewers.
Do you think that maybe 10 is the correct age that we should be sending our children out into the
maybe
world?
Maybe not.
But to become Pokemon masters.
If you are 10 and you want to go out into the world, pick up a DS, play Pokemon, you can go out essentially, digitally, virtually, into the Pokemon region and catch your own. And you, who knows, you catch them all, you might even catch up with Rick.
Oh, Nate, I mean, just, wow. When I have kids...
I just went deep there.
When I have kids, you are going to be their mentor, I've decided.
It's fine.
There you are.
Standard.
Just
thanks for sending in your question.
Yeah. In a Pokemon show.
Absolutely.
Classic.
Thanks for sending in your question, Glory O'Shea. Keep them coming in. We do enjoy reading
Last
them.
Week we had a lot of Pokemon jokes, and I enjoyed that. So if anybody has any Pokemon-related humour...
Anything to share would be great.
That'd be awesome. What have we got coming up on the show?
We've got coming up on the show still to come. We've got our caption competition that we've been doing weekly. We're going to show the first view of that shortly.
We will, indeed.
Where we give you a picture from an episode. And...
That I found funny.
Yeah, that we find funny. And make your own captions to the image. And... we'll judge which one makes us laugh the most, and you can win a booster pack of how many?
I believe it's 10.
10?
10.
Official Pokemon cards in the booster pack, which will be coming from the Dark Explorers expansion.
Next week it'll be the Dragon.
Yeah, well.
It's Exalted. But don't let that stop you from taking part.
No, absolutely.
I mean, there's still some good cards in that. We've also got... a recap of Who's That Pokemon.
Yep.
We've got my episode of the week, part 2.
I'm looking forward to see what's happening there.
We've got my Pokemon of the week and Nate's Pokemon card of the week. We have got a lot to get through. Let's get cracking on with this. That's what I say. But first we'll play a song.
And we are doing HM theme songs today.
We are indeed. So, like, you're rocking around in the Safari Zone, okay? And you're trying to catch you some... Maybe you're trying to get yourself a Taurus. You're trying to get yourself a Kangaskhan. Maybe a Pinsir. Cypher. Who knows what you're after? I'm not saying...
I always try and get a Dratini.
Maybe, like, you were even after just a Nidoran. I mean, you've paid your money, you've got your balls, you go and catch what you want. You come across, like, a hut, though, and you're like, what's going on in this hut? But, I mean, you've got to get deep into Safari Zone. You've got to get into real...
You've got to find that. It's
real,
not just
hard
a case
to find place. And you get into this... You get into this house and this guy's like, well, you found me. You've won this prize. People are really nice in the Pokemon world. They just give stuff away.
They are. But I think he's looking for something, isn't he? He kind of... He's having trouble talking right now.
I believe he's having, a kind of...
a crisis.
In the mouth department. I mean, I've had crises in the mouth department before. I mean, it's pretty serious. And I mean... Well, I've got myself a gold tooth, so I'll give it to him.
Yeah.
And as a result, if I wanted to go surfing, I'd certainly go surfing USA.
If everybody had a nose across the she born here? Surfing USA.
HMO3, USA.
By the Beach Boys.
Yeah, we did. Right, let's crack on. What have we got?
We have got...
We're running out of time.
Card. Oh, I'm going to do a jingle for this. Hang on.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I expect it.
Oh, look at that.
Pokemon card of the week.
Sorry, I will just...
You did just interrupt my jingle.
I saw that Pokemon art and it's... Oh, yeah, man, it's serious.
That link should be on our Facebook page. Check it out. The one we had
emailed. If it's not
in.
Now, we will put it on it.
It's amazing.
Must check it out.
Well done to whoever did that, because it's serious.
It's mega serious.
I like it very much. Up next...
Yep.
We've got a Pokemon card of the week.
Yeah, go for it, Nick.
I've been thinking a lot about this recently. Mm. I thought, I've been featuring X cards quite a lot.
Yeah, you are pretty X heavy.
I am. I used to have a deck full of X's, but then battles were over in like 3 minutes because every time an X card dies, your opponent takes 2 prize cards, which means battles last a less amount of time, and although they're very strong, that's their downfall. However, this week I thought I'm going to change it up a little bit and I'm going to go with a non-X card. So we're going to put the picture of my card up on the webcam for you guys to check out. It is the card of Zekrom, and I am showing the full art card here because it's beautiful. The illustrator did a really good job. It was one of the first cards I got out of the... what's the Emerging Powers? That's it. The Emerging Powers expansion.
We've
got a phone call.
Do we?
Yeah. Should we see who's on? Oh, he's on line one. Here we go.
Why not?
Hello.
Hello.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
Oh, hi. My name's Nigel.
How are you?
Well, I could be better, to be honest.
Yeah.
This is really embarrassing.
Carry on.
My polyrath has locked itself in its shed.
Why are you keeping your polyrath in a shed?
No. Look, we were playing.
Yeah.
It kind of used hydro pump and it backfired and he ended up landing in a shed and then the shed locked.
We've all been there.
To be honest, I should have rung last week because he's been in there for a good 2 weeks now.
He's been in, if you got like, is there maybe a crack in the window that you can put some rare candy through?
I really don't know.
What other Pokemon do you have? Do you, by any chance, have like something like a Diglett or a Sandshrew that may be capable of using Dig to get underneath the shed?
I only have water type.
You're only a water type Pokemon, okay?
Yeah. Okay. I mean, Lapras can't be bothered doing anything. You know what? I'm thinking about selling my Lapras because it's pain in the bum.
Oh, really?
If you don't mind me saying.
What? Pain in the bum in the same way that Pikachu is for Ash.
Yeah.
Does he not?
Damn right.
What level is your Lapras and what is your gym leader situation? That might be part of your problem.
Maybe
you should focus on getting some more gym badges and then maybe that Lapras might take you more seriously.
It's the Ash and Charizard situation all over again.
It is. And I can remember saying to Ash at the time when that was going on. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Is he out? It's out.
Well, congratulations.
That's a relief.
You need to get into Nurse Joy right now.
Okay. It wants to say something to you guys.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, cool. Put him on.
It's actually not talking now. I better feed it because it's pretty.
Yeah, that's
pretty
cool,
starving.
Man. You take care of your Polyrath, man.
I will. Oh, can I ask a question?
Of course you can.
What's your favourite Pokemon and why? And that goes to Emma McGann.
Emma McGann's not in the studio right now, but I feel confident enough to speak for her, and I think that Emma McGann's favourite Pokemon is Spoink, the pig Pokemon.
Okay. Definitely Spoink.
But I know it causes her a lot of trouble because, as we all know, if Spoink isn't hopping around, then its heart stops.
Oh, no.
So Spoink has always...
I've got a question for Rich, if it's okay, quickly.
Yeah, go for it.
Rich.
Yeah?
If you had to pick three Pokemon to beatbox with, as in, say, their names as a beatbox, which Pokemon would it be? And why?
Well, you got to hit yourself some hard consonants there. You can't be saying like Charit. No, it's not cool.
I think I've got one.
Yeah, go for it.
Hitmonchan. There we go.
Oh,
that's my.
That's cool.
Not like
you got the chan for the snare.
Yeah,
not like
Bulbasaur.
That's cool. That's cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then obviously Diglett. Why wouldn't you? Why wouldn't you beatbox with Diglett?
You could always do Articuno Jinx, Zapdos Jinx. I quite like that.
Give me some.
Articuno Jinx, Zapdos Jinx, Articuno Jinx, Zapdos Jinx, Articuno Jinx, Zapdos Jinx. Like that.
I like that.
Well done.
Yeah?
I like that.
There's quite a few people looking at me in the pallet town right now. They're kind of looking at me quite scared.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
I better go.
Take care of that Polyrath.
It's gone.
Saw your Polyrath out, Nigel. Sort him out.
Polly.
We'll see Nigel again.
I better go, guys.
Yeah, thanks for calling in, Nigel.
Bye, Nigel.
No worries. Bye.
Oh, man. I hope he has some luck with his Polyrath.
Yeah,
he sounded like a nice guy.
It's an unfortunate situation right there.
He sounded like a nice guy.
Yeah, he did.
He did. What were we doing? You're in the middle of your Pokemon
card. Yeah, my Pokemon card of the week. Thanks for calling in, guys. My Pokemon card of the week is Zekrom, because...
Yeah, Zekrom. What?
Yeah, I'll
just
put it up on the webcam right now, because I thought, I don't want to go with another X, because...
Yeah, you don't want to be labelled as just like an X maniac.
Yeah, exactly. I mean... I like other cards as well. Zekrom, I've shown the full art one because it is amazing. But Zekrom has a very good move that I use quite a lot. And I think you saw in the first card battle against myself and Ace Trainer James, it was quite effective against James's Pokemon. The move is Outrage, which means that the more damage Zekrom takes, the more damage he gives out. So the weaker he becomes... the stronger his attack gets. So this is very useful because it kind of gives that element of decision making to your opponent. Do I attack Zekrom? If I can't kill him, do I bother to attack him because he's just going to get a lot stronger? And that move is Outrage, and it only takes two energies of any kind, which is also really useful. It's got a massive 130 HP, which is quite a lot for an X card. Standard, because it's electricity, weak to fighting, times two. But it also has a move called Bolt Strike, which takes two electric energies and one any energy. It does 120 damage. However, the Pokemon does 40 damage to itself. But, so that's a risky move, but by doing 40 damage to yourself, you're essentially increasing the move Outrage even more. So
the way that works is Outrage does 20 damage regardless of what damage the Pokemon has on itself. But for, say, like, your Zekrom has 60... It's got 60 damage counters on it. Then that Pokemon would do the 20...
Plus the 60.
So you're looking at 80.
If you think about, if Zekrom ever gets down to 10 HP left, you're going to be dealing 140 damage. There's not many cards that can take that.
You're in trouble.
Yeah, there's... So, it's a win-win.
Would you like to know a piece of useless trivia about that card?
I would.
That's happened in my life.
Okay.
I was given, as a present from a certain gentleman returning from Tenerife, some... what can only be described as cheap booster packs. And in one of my booster packs was a Zekrom full art card. Now, I'm 100% certain that this card was a mega fake, because rather than... There were certain things that gave it away. The fact that it was actually paper and somebody had just
that's
printed
always
it on
that's
the
always
paper.
A giveaway.
And also, rather than saying retreat, it said retreat. And there were some definite spelling mistakes. But nevertheless, it was a lovely present from that gentleman returning from Tenerife. That gentleman who's refusing to acknowledge that I'm talking about him now.
Hey.
That's you, James.
Ace Trainer James.
Again, I don't recommend that you give anybody fake Pokemon cards.
No, why would you when the real ones are so much better?
Yeah, there you are.
Is that card?
Oh man, we've got a question which...
Okay,
I don't know if I can answer. This is a serious question. Delonte has sent us a message asking... I wanted to know if you guys think that Magikarp is better than Feebas. Now, Magikarp, obviously, terrible Pokemon. Learns, like, Tackle at 15. Feebas is a very similar Pokemon. It's a fish Pokemon. But you need to give it... I think it's a prism scale or something like that, and then it evolves into Milotic, which is a pretty bad boy water Pokemon.
Serious.
So they're very similar in that respect, in that they're both useless until you evolve them.
I'm going to give my answer and say that Phoebus is better.
Really?
Because it's rarer.
It's
quite hard to find.
Yeah.
And you have to surf up and down that lake, that one lake, on gold. No, is it gold? To find
no,
it.
No, you mean it because it's a Gen 3, so you're talking Ruby or Sapphire.
Yeah, it was really hard to find. I spent ages trying to get Phoebus, just for Milotic.
I mean, there's two sides to the story. Milotic is a pretty cool Pokemon, but then again, so is Gyarados. I mean, it's a dragon.
Yeah,
well, I don't know, it's not a dragon type, but it's Gyarados is a lot cooler. Milotic is just a... It doesn't look as cool as Gyarados.
No.
But... Yeah, I'm going to have to go with Magikarp, just for the fact that it evolves at level 20. You don't have to worry about... It's not difficult to find. It is completely useless, but Gyarados is also super awesome.
You should see me at level 20.
You should see Nate at level 20. You really should. He got to level 20 a couple of nights ago, and let's just say it got awesome.
It did.
Stuff got awesome.
So, that's Pokemon Card of the Week done.
Indeed.
Would you like to do Pokemon of the Week?
We
can move on to the caption contest first, if you like.
Yeah, stick the caption contest.
Okay, so, as I explained earlier, we take a picture from an episode that Rick finds funny, and...
I do.
We ask you... to write your own caption to it. This picture, I'm about to put it on the webcam. However, it will be available all week long. You've got a week to get involved in this. It's going to be on the Facebook page, Pokemania, facebook.com/PokemaniaFM. It's going to be on, I think it might be on Twitter probably. Just head over to those places if you wish to see it. Don't forget you can send your answers in to 60777, start your text with the word study box. Or if you're going to email, you can email the radio at studybox.com or tweet at studyboxfm. If you could also leave a name and a way of contacting you if you are our winner, that would be very helpful. Do you want to give an example of that, Rick?
Oh, you want me to get like... So, I don't know. I'm just going to go on my phone and I'm going to text. I'll be like, all right, so I'm going to type in 60777. Then, of course, I've got to type in StudyVox, StudyVox. Right, so then I'm going to put my name in. And my name is, this week, I'm going to go with Keith.
Keith, yeah.
I like Keith.
Keith.
I like Keith.
I like Keith.
Everybody likes Keith. So, hi, my name's Keith, and my guess for Pokemon of the Week. I'm not going to go caption competition because I'll give it away before you even see it. My guess for Pokemon of the Week is it'd be a... I can't think. Why would I try and enter this competition if I don't have
I think you should go for
clear
like
fault in my
Ditto.
But it doesn't have wings.
It could. It could do anything.
But by that logic then Ditto is every Pokemon. Like it's everyone we've done.
Absolutely.
Nah.
Anyway, here's the picture for caption.
Slap it up, James.
So that is a picture. If you are listening on audio only, it's a picture of Misty's feet
and legs. There's definitely some leg there.
A Weedle trying to crawl its way up Misty's leg.
Well, we assume that's what the Weedle's trying to do.
Yeah, but what do you think he's trying to do? That's our question to you. Write your captions. Send them in.
Last week's caption competition was, of course, the wonderful the one with the Caterpie. Bug themed.
We had a winner.
We did have a winner, and we're going to announce that winner now. And our winner is C. What he did is he emailed us, so we got that.
Yeah, we got his email address.
So we've got his email address so we can send him things.
What was his caption?
His caption was, Caterpie used Harden. Caterpie used String Shot. Misty's speed was lowered. Misty used Screech.
That's a very good caption. Clever caption.
That's from Scrimmy. So congratulations, Scrimmy. You are a winner of our caption competition.
Woohoo!
We will be sent... Yeah! We will be sending you a booster pack containing how many cards, Nate?
I think it's one, two... Oh, it's ten.
Oh, ten!
Ten, yeah.
Sweet.
Ten?
That's right. We'll be sending
ten
you...
whole cards.
Mm-hmm.
Just for you.
He's actually just emailed us as well.
Oh, really? Scrimmy? What's he say?
What does Eevee evolve into you when you give Eevee a French stone?
A what, sorry?
A French stone.
Frenchy?
Napoleon.
Yes. That's brilliant. That's very good. Actually, that deserves a...
You love that bird.
Yeah. I do love that bird.
See, keep the jokes coming in. I
Absolutely.
Love it. Thank you very much. So, well done, Scrimmy. You are our winner. We'll be sending you that booster pack containing how many cards, Nate?
Ten.
Oh, ten. Sweet.
So, we've still got our second half of episode of the week.
We've got that.
And we've got Pokemon of the Week.
Yeah, we do.
And we've got some things about a monthly contest we're going to explain to you shortly.
Oh, we will indeed. But first, I think we should play a song. We've got a lot to get through. But, you know, like, obviously...
When we're in a dark place.
Sometimes you get down and you get into a dark place. And, maybe one of your Pokemon might be lucky enough to know HMO5. And I know that... A certain Brian May and Mr. Freddie Mercury, their Pokemon knew Flash, so they thought maybe I'd write a song about it. That they later became a movie, but that's not important. So this is Queen with HMO5.
Just a man with a man's courage.
There we go. HMO 5.
Flash.
Sorry.
That definitely brought me out of a dark place.
Yeah, man. I mean, like... Yeah.
I was just running around bumping into walls.
And the occasional trainer.
Yeah, it's, and the occasional Zubat.
Oh, they're everywhere, man. They're everywhere. Right, let's crack on. Less of this Pokemon banter and more about the things that we have to do.
So,
yeah.
Should we do Who's That Pokemon? No, we've done the Who's That Pokemon, but we could do the second view.
We'll do the second view of Who's That Pokemon, okay? So we've had some guesses for Who's That Pokemon. Matt Overton went with a guess that was remarkably close to the...
Yes, it was.
So good work, Matt Overton, but stop taking photos of me. Fact. Anyway, so the original Who's That Pokemon, the first clue I gave you was, it flies so silently through the dark on its four wings that it may not even be noticed. Even when nearby. So the second clue I'm going to give you is from the Platinum Pokedex, and it says, the transformation of its legs into wings made it better at flying, but more clumsy at walking.
Oh, okay, so it used to walk. So again, this gives me the idea that it's an evolved Pokemon.
Mm-hmm. Good thought process. I like how Nintendo had to point out that it was just like, obviously the transformation of its legs into wings made it better at flying, but more clumsy at walking. Well, thanks.
Yeah,
if I had winged legs, I'd find it difficult to walk.
But easily to fly.
You'd hope so, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I would. I would hope so.
But anyway, those are your cues for Who's That Pokemon.
Good work.
If you have any clue, you, of course, can text us in at 60777. Start your text with StudyVox, then your guess, then a name, or your name, then a guess. I don't really care which way around they go. You can email us at radio@studyvox.com or Twitter @StudyVoxFM. You can put your guesses on our Facebook page. Wow, there's a lot of ways for you to enter this competition.
Yes,
no excuse
is.
Not to, then.
No. So,
yeah.
Pokemon of the week.
You'd like me to do my Pokemon of the week?
Yeah, I would. I'm excited for this.
Right, okay. But let's see if you can... First of all, let's see if you can guess what my Pokemon of the week is.
Okay.
Its height is 6'3".
So taller than Charizard, which we established earlier on in one of the shows.
Yeah. Taller than me and you. Its weight is 209.4 pounds, or if you'd like that in maybe a different way, is 95 kilograms. Got any clues yet from the size of it?
Can I ask a question?
Yeah.
Does it stand on two legs?
It does stand on two legs. Its type is Dragon Ground.
Dragon Ground.
It's from the fourth generation of the games.
I'm at a loss.
You're at a loss? My Pokemon of the week is Garchomp.
Good work.
Garchomp's serious. Dragon Ground, I like that. Just because of its Dragon Ground type, it means that it's got very little weaknesses. It does have a x4 weakness to ice and a x2 weakness to dragon, but those are its only weaknesses. How cool is that?
That's very cool.
It's very resistant to a lot of Pokemon as well. So, but just the ice and the dragon, that's where it is. But only two weaknesses is rare nowadays.
That is rare.
So its base stats are pretty cool. It's got HP 108, which isn't bad. Defense 95. Special attack 80. Not great. Special defense 85. Speed 102. So it's fairly quick,
it's quick.
Pokemon. But its attack is 130.
Wow.
That's pretty big.
That's huge.
That's just base stats. So, as you can tell, it's quite the hard hitting Pokemon. And,
yeah. Fast and hard hitting. I like that.
So I've been using one recently. I mean, you've got to go and get yourself a Gibble, which again, my good friend Shuckle Tamer Dan, his name, he gave him this name. I didn't have anything to do with it. He just went, "Can you call
Shuckle
me
Tamer?"
Shuckle Tamer Dan. He was going on my game trying to find a Gibble so he could trade it across. Gibble evolves into Gabite, which then evolves into Garchomp at like level 48.
So yeah.
Like most dragon Pokemon, you've got a high level you've got to get to before it evolves into its bad boy form. But Garchomp is wicked. And one of the things I like about it as well is if you take it to a move tutor in Black and White, you can teach it Draco Meteor, which is a massive,
now,
massive dragon move.
This move, that move
messed
was used against
last
me last week, yeah. Against Ace Trainer James. Which Pokemon was it that used it?
He probably used you had the Kurem, which used it. He had Reshiram, I think, which used it.
Ah. Yeah, it was. Yes, it was.
And it's wicked because its attack is 140, which is massive for a move.
That's huge.
Its accuracy is only 90, but I mean, as you can see, last week it paid off. Really paid off and mucked about with some of the dragon. Because a lot of types that people use are something then dragon. Like, for example, Garchomp, dragon ground.
Yeah.
So dragon moves will mess that up. And Draco Meteor is probably the biggest one. It's my favourite dragon move. I quite like it. Black and White Pokedex describes it as, it is said that when one runs at high speeds, its wings create blades of wind that can fell nearby trees.
Wow. This is a...
So they just absolutely power it around.
Knocking down trees. I'd like myself one of those.
Causing trouble. And they look pretty funky as well. Nice blue things with wings.
Yeah.
And a pretty angry looking mouth. Like,
bigger than Charizard as well.
Massive. Oh! I believe James has put... Look at that.
We have a picture of Garchomp.
Look how cool he is. There he is. He's... Imagine a 6 foot three, 95 kilogram one of those bad boys.
Yes.
Messing with your trees.
I would not.
Don't let him loose in your back garden.
So that's your Pokemon of the week.
That is indeed.
Good choice. I like that choice. I didn't expect that choice either.
See, what I wanted to do was like I've done every week. The first week was Charizard, then I did Tyranitar, then I did Aggron. Now I've done Garchomp, so I've done one from every generation.
That's cool.
So next week, maybe.
Now, why are you doing these Pokemon of the week? These Pokemon of the week.
I'm doing these Pokemon of the week. Oh, look, we've got a phone call.
Oh, we've got another phone call.
Oh, hang on. Answer that phone, James. You need to answer the phone.
Oh.
Stop just go. Pushing random things and that. Man, I'm panicking. Hello? Hello there?
Hello?
Oh, hello?
Oh, hello?
Oh, hello?
Hi there, you're live on Surrey Vox FM on the Pokemania Show. What would you like to say? Hello?
Hello?
My name's...
Hey, Professor Brown. What's going on?
I am a big fan of your show.
That's incredibly
Especially
nice.
Especially Nathan.
Oh, that's really nice of you to say.
Thank you.
What a dream. That's Nathan. Anyway.
May I ask, what are you a professor of?
The reason I'm phoning this fine evening is because I've invented a new Pokeball.
Oh, really? Well, I'm a big fan of Pokeballs.
Oh, I'm sure you're a big fan of balls. I've invented a new Pokeball, and I've named it after myself. It's a brown ball.
Oh, well, I know there aren't many balls that are even close to brown, so...
No.
Good decision on
yes.
that. And what does it do?
It catches brown Pokemon.
Okay.
You'll be getting Dugtrio so easy.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, there's thousands. There's literally thousands.
Literally thousands of brown Pokemon.
A Kabuto, or a Noctowl, or a Furret, or a Pillowswine,
yeah.
or a Nuzleaf.
Yeah.
Or a Kangaskhan.
Does it work better the browner the Pokemon, or like say a Pokemon with only a small amount of brown on it?
The browner the Pokemon, the sweeter the catch.
Oh, so like Pikachu that has a little bit of brown on his tail.
It wouldn't
work so well on him, but like
a
Pillowswine, which is pretty much just brown, you'd catch that a treat.
Pretty much just brown.
Yeah. Yeah?
I like brown.
Thanks for that, Professor Brown.
I assume you do.
So, how's the show going?
it's going well, thank you for asking.
Oh,
have you perchance listened to any of the competitions? What is your expert opinion on who's that Pokemon? I can tell you it's not brown, so maybe you won't get it.
I'm going to guess...
Yeah.
And go for Weedle.
Weedle.
Okay. Because Weedle is slightly brown.
Weedle is slightly brown. It's a good guess.
Maybe you're right. Maybe you're correct. We'll find out on next week's show. Thank you for calling in, Professor Brown.
Thanks, Professor Brown.
No worries.
Goodbye, Professor Brown.
I'll be sending you...
Nate, did you just cut him off?
No, we've lost him.
Oh, that was Professor Brown, everybody. We've had some guesses in. We've had Woobat, I guess. Maybe that's right. I don't know. Maybe it's right.
It could be Woobat.
Somebody guessed Garchomp. Do you think I'd really be... Who's that Pokemon be the same as the Pokemon of the week?
Clever. I wouldn't guess it.
No, I wouldn't go there, no. Fair enough. All right, see what you're saying.
Why are we doing these Pokemon of the Weeks?
We're doing these... No, not Pokemon of the Weeks. Who's that Poke... No, yeah, no, you're right. Sorry, I tried to correct you.
Pokemon of the Week.
Preschooler Rich here. Duh. We are doing these Pokemon of the Weeks because... At the end of this month, our fifth week, I will be giving away a fully EV-trained level 100 Pokemon.
Wow.
And that Pokemon will be one of my previous Pokemon of the Weeks.
Really?
So, for example, it could be Charizard, it could be Tyranitar, it could be Aggron, or it could be this week's Garchomp.
And we'll be giving that away to one lucky winner.
Mm.
But you don't how do they get involved?
Next week I'll be asking the question, which of those Pokemon... do you think will be my EV trained level 100 Pokemon? And if you get it right, all those names will be in a hat, and we'll pick the winner from that. We'll only accept your first answer. Let's not bombard us with all five. That won't improve your chances.
No.
We'll only accept your first
answer.
So that's what will be happening next week. We've had an email in.
Have we? Who's it from?
Simply titled Clefable versus Wigglytuff.
Wow, standard. Makes me want to read on.
I'm putting together a team of normal types on Pokemon Fire Red. I have 5 slots filled, and I'm looking for the 6th Pokemon. The 2 Pokemon I'm considering are Clefable and Wigglytuff. Which one do you guys think is better?
This is a tough one.
They're very similar Pokemon.
They are.
Whatever happens, I think you should definitely give one of them Metronome, because I love that move.
That's the move where it could be anything. Yeah, that's a very good move.
It just makes battling so much more ridiculous.
I think I taught my Togekiss Metronome. It's a good move.
Did you?
Yeah, it's a very good move. Because you never know what you're going to get. It could be amazing.
Well,
or it could be Growl.
Well, it's difficult because, I mean, obviously you're going to need your Moonstone to evolve both of them.
Yeah, absolutely.
They're very similar Pokemon from what I can remember.
It's down to personal preference, isn't it, really?
I think I'd personally go with Wigglytuff. For the pure reason that I think it looks cooler.
Fair enough.
And by cooler, I of course mean more ridiculous. But still, it's a difficult one. Why are you going for a team of all normals, is my question. I'm assuming, like, you've got Snorlax in there.
The tank.
You've probably got yourself a... what is it? Is it Slaking? I probably have one of those.
Hopefully you've got yourself a Togekiss.
Yeah, actually, they're as far as normal... I'm not the biggest fan of normal Pokemon, but as far as normal Pokemon go...
A Druidigun.
It's a dragon Pokemon.
Oh, is it?
Just stop... Tame those dragons.
No, I'm thinking of the...
Kecleon. I'd give yourself a Kecleon.
Who does
Herdia
evolve into?
You mean Stoutland?
Yes.
Yep.
Another tank.
But I think that's like dark as well, isn't it? Or is it? No, it's just normal.
It's normal.
You got to watch out for those fighting Pokemon right there. Hopefully.
So you'd go with Wigglytuff.
I'd go with Wigglytuff. For the...
I'm going to say Clefable, so that really doesn't help your situation, does it?
Well, I know Wigglytuff has like got a mega... Like, its base HP is massive. That's why I'd go for it.
Yeah.
I mean, the rest of its defense, I believe, and speed are pretty shocking, but I know its HP is pretty big.
Yeah.
So that's why I'd go for it. I always remember it having mega amounts of HP, and the more HP you have, the better for everyone involved.
Absolutely.
So there you are. We're vastly approaching the end of our show. Rapidly, yeah. In fact, that's what I should have said.
Should we play a song?
Okay, we'll slap a song in, and then I'll get on with the rest of my episode of the week.
Yes.
That should see us out towards the end. So, unless you've been not listening to the show up until now, you probably realise that there's a HM theme going on.
We've had Waterfall, we've had Strength, we've had Surf, we've had Flash, we've had Fly. So obviously, we've got to go with the original, HM1. And that gets you into some serious places. But Bryan Adams has been on the... His Pokemon have been on the wrong side of that move. And I imagine... And he says that it cuts like a knife.
Cuts.
HMO1's like a knife.
Oh, it does.
Oh, man, Bryan Adams, sing it. His Pokemon have clearly been on the wrong end of a...
They have.
A cut... monstrosity. There you are. We're coming up towards the end of the show, so I think we better get on with this.
Are we finishing story time with Rick?
I think we are, yeah.
I'll stop the backing for you.
Oh, please, thank you.
Here we go.
Okay, so as you remember, we left off when a Pidgeotto... was not willing to get inside Ash's Pokeball. So Ash has decided to assault it with his newly caught Caterpie. You know, we laugh now. We know how silly that decision is. Flying versus Bug. Especially when you've got a Pikachu as well. But I know what he's trying to do. He's trying to, you know, build Caterpie's self-esteem up after Misty's.
Yeah.
Horrible words. So anyway, Ash sends out his Caterpie and, well, it orders it to attack, but... Pidgeotto is having none of it. Mashes that Cat P up, sends it spiraling into a tree, and it's obviously, you know, KO'd right there. Ash doesn't have a clue what he's doing. Pidgeotto is swooping around, coming in for another attack, but Misty shouts that Ash should recall Caterpie, so he does that. But just in time, just as he recalls it, the Pidgeotto swoops into attack, misses the Caterpie, and gets its beak stuck in a tree.
Oh, man.
Looked out there, Ash. You looked out there. So the Pidgeotto frees himself, and Ash finally comes to his senses and sends Pikachu after him. Because Pikachu's electric. He's going to mess Pidgeotto up. There's no way around that. So Pikachu uses Thunder Shock to hit Pidgeotto, and it weakens it, allowing Ash to throw his Pokeball and into the Pokeball, drops to the ground, rocks backwards and forwards. A few moments, you know, a couple of camera shots. Ball, Ash's face, Pokeball, Ash's face, Pokeball, Pikachu, Pokeball. And then guess what happens, guys? Guess what happens? He captures the Pidgeotto.
Yay,
that's correct. I was happy for him. But Misty, still not happy with this. She continues to absolutely slam into him about his lack of knowledge and strategy in the Pokemon. Well, I mean, like, come on, bug Pokemon against flying.
And we can't all wait for Pokemon to run into a tree to catch them.
No, we can't, Ash, you lucky bad boy. But, you know, Misty's mocking him, and Ash is sitting there thinking, wow, this moment can't get any worse. Wrong! Team Rocket show up. Jesse.
James.
Oh, wait, no. Oh, I can't do it.
No.
I can't do it. Never
they're
mind.
For trouble, basically.
Yeah, they're there.
Make
the,
it double,
the motto
you know.
Comes out. Oh, and then they're all about Pikachu right now. They want it. They want that Pikachu because it's Pikachu's pretty bad boy. Without Pikachu, Ash would just be the worst guy ever. Should be walking around a forest with a Caterpie trying to take on bird
and
Pokemon.
A Pidgeotto.
Well, now he's got the Pidgeotto, but only because of Pikachu. Ash. So anyway, Team Rocket's shown up and they chuck out their coffins and Ekans. They chuck them into battle. I mean, despite the double team being unfair, Misty is just like, all right, I'll jump in, but Ash doesn't want any of this. He doesn't want to break the rules. I don't see why that's breaking the rules. And Koffin uses Sludge, and it, well, blinds Pikachu. And Pikachu's well out of the battle, man. They're in trouble. Well, he hands the Pikachu to Misty. Pikachu's got this funny, pretty funny brown splodge around his face, which means he can't see. You know, standard. So Ash is deciding that he'll take him on himself. He'll take, and what other Pokemon's he going to use? Well, obviously he's going to use his Pidgeotto.
Yeah, he's got a new Pidgeotto.
But will Ash make that decision?